Hey guys, so I wanted to do a video because I don't do them very often, and I wanted to offer some formations for some of my new subscribers or new listeners. And you know, these are many of these things I've gone over before, but I've been told by my subscribers that I should, people don't go back and watch your old videos. So let me just, you know, for the people that I've met recently, it sounds crazy, the things that I'm saying, and I get that, but let me bring you the receipts, so to speak. It's going to be a little jumbled because this is just stuff that I wrote on the back of my old employee handbook. I'll start with this. Today's laws cannot abridge laws in the past regarding the Constitution. Any law that is passed through legislation or otherwise is null and void because it's unconstitutional. That's a fact. Furthermore, all of the contracts previous, such as the Magna Carta, right, 1215, the Declaration of Independence, the Articles of Confederation, you have the Federalist Papers, the Anti-Federalist Papers, excuse me, all of those contracts are withstanding unless they protect the people's rights less than a subsequent contract. This is because of enabling clauses. This is how a law came into being. Everything from before is brought forward or made stronger or delineated in the people's favor. That's the law. That's the law as it pertains to living beings, the people. So now, excuse me, let's go back to what I've been speaking to a lot of people about, which is, do you need a driver's license if you're not making money while you're traveling in that personal automobile or not your automobile? You are absolutely not a driver unless you are making commerce at that moment. So let me just read you the lineage of Supreme Court cases and decisions that back that up. Sorry for Callaway. He's a jackwagon. Shapiro versus Thompson. All citizens are free to travel throughout the United States uninhibited by statutes, rules, or regulations which unreasonably burden or restrict this movement. If a law has no other purpose other than to chill assertions of constitutional rights by penalizing those who choose to exercise them, it is patently unconstitutional. That's a withstanding Supreme Court case, Shapiro versus Thompson. Okay? Withstanding. Let's back that up. Oh, let me just, you know, go a little bit more on that. They also say the purpose of inhibiting migration by needy persons into a state is constitutionally impermissible. And you can say, I have the right to travel freely and unencumbered. You have that right. That's a right so basic it doesn't have to be written on paper. You can go where you want. This is your land. After that, it was challenged again. Then we had Murdoch versus the state of Pennsylvania. No right shall be converted into a privilege. You have the right to free speech. Can they charge you for it and turn it into a privilege? A right is not a privilege. A privilege is something that you have given permission to do from your servant, your subservient entity. challenged again. Shuttlesworth versus Birmingham, Alabama. No state may convert a secured liberty into a privilege and issue a license and a fee for it. If they do, you could ignore it with impunity. These are withstanding Supreme Court cases, okay? These are laws in the books, black and white, that supersede codes and statutes from the Uniform Commercial Code. If you don't know what the Uniform Commercial Code is, first of all, you need to buy the book, The UCC Connection, and read it. And you might have to read it a few times, okay? It's not something you can pick up. Maybe some of you can pick it up quick. But it's vital that you comprehend it. If you want to know how to communicate your standing, you have a contractual standing. Everything is contractual. Your country is contractual. All other countries are contractual. Your relationship with your country is contractual. Your relationship with the corporation known as the United States is contractual. Everything's contractual. It'd be a good idea to know how a contract works and how what your standing is, you know. Let's say you have a contract and one person, one individual, or one entity in the contract is the one that has all the power and all the say, and the other entity doesn't. Wouldn't you want to know if you're the one that has all the power? Especially if you're being treated like you're the one that doesn't? Kind of important information to know. Anyway, that's all I got. Love you guys. Take care.